Arabic.
This is many questions.
Brother, stop lying.
Wow.
Why do you lie so much?
I didn't understand it.
So, okay, can you read or understand it? Okay, okay. He's going to give you the Arabic. Okay, give him the Arabic. Give him the Arabic. Give him the Arabic.
I will give you the Arabic.
You're not more like John Rambo than me, mate.
No, you said you're John Rambo.
You're John Rambo. Let's go. Let's go. Yeah, yeah, okay. John Doe. Okay. Okay.
John Doe.
All right, let's go. Yeah.
Can you read this for us?
Yes. Read that aloud. Read that aloud.
Yeah, please. Can you read that aloud?
I'm trying to read it myself in my head first.
I think he's trying to buy a time.
Do you know what this is about? Already, I actually
read it. Oh, read it. Read it. We ask you. We ask you. Can you read it?
John Doe.
Read it out loud.
Read it. Read it out loud. Because we got English people here, and the cameras for English.
You are so kind. Okay. You teach me.
Read it. Read it. Read it.
John Doe. John Doe.
Where were you when I was?
Read the question.
All right,
brother. No, this is diverting. No, is he trying to change the subject? No, is that he's afraid to answer the question? My friend, answer the question. Answer the question. Stop trying to avoid it. Answer the question. My friend, read the question. Read the verse. Read the verse first. Read the verse first. No, no, read the verse. We don't know.
Read it. You want to divorce your wife, and then if you want to remarry her, the condition is she has to have 3 months separation.
Who?
And then remarry and
But there are three types of people here. Yeah. Which type of people are you talking about?
Yes.
There are three verse groups
four.
Of people here.
Do you understand the verse? Do you understand the verse?
Read the first two verses before.
Read it for us.
Well, okay. Read. It doesn't matter if you read it.
Whether you read this and that, this gives you the meaning.
Yeah,
you can read that. You're wasting your time, sir. 65 verse 4. I'll read it. Okay,
read it.
And those who no longer expect menstruation among your women, if you doubt, then their period is 3 months.
What do you mean by menstruation?
Wait, I didn't finish.
Wait. You get an opportunity to respond. You get an opportunity to respond.
Listen to this one. This is the punchline.
Yes.
This is the punchline.
Listen.
Watch.
Listen.
And also for those who have not yet menstruated.
Right.
And for those who have not menstruated.
You look surprised.
Those who are they who have
first
not menstruated?
Of all, for those who don't understand the word, explain that word, menstruated. Explain to those
sir,
who
don't. You don't know what menstruated means?
I know, but.
Okay, so we're asking you. We're asking you. You don't know, we're asking you. Listen, don't hide. Listen.
You're hiding.
Don't be hiding someone else. Okay, okay, yeah.
You're hiding.
Okay. Don't answer. Don't hide. My friend, my friend, don't hide behind, someone else.
Tell me, John Doe.
Okay,
John Doe.
So, no, don't let him get a chance. Don't let him avoid the question.
Help me, my pop brain.
Okay, he's gonna help you.
Okay.
That your prophet was given. I answer your question. Iqra, recite.
Okay.
Menstruation. What does that mean? Anybody, most people in here have been to school. Whether you say it in Arabic, in English, in Tigrinya, everybody knows.
Yes.
Yes. So you know what it means? We all know what it means.
Thank you.
Okay. We all know what it means. So, back to the question. Back to it. Back to the question. Don't let him avoid this. You're not avoiding this.
So, those who have not menstruated, yeah? Their periods are 3 months. So that means they were married already.
You no longer expect menstruation among your women. If you doubt, then they're very quick. And we'll provide for them that there is the zone. And whoever applies upon Allah, then he's sufficient. I know.
It's this one, brother. Don't waste your time.
And those who not. But what's it talking? It's talking about something about marriage.
You're wasting your time, sir.
Marriage.
Read verse 4. We know it's
what did
marriage.
You say? What did you say? Yeah.
So what's the problem? Did
you not hear what he just said? Did you not hear?
Repeat
again. Repeat. Help him out. Help him out.
Those who have not yet menstruated, yeah, their period is 3 months before they get divorced.
Right.
So they were married already. So those who have not menstruated can be 3 years old.
Right. Right.
Who hits purity? At what age do you hit purity?
Going back to what I said together.
Right.
At what age do you hit purity?
Oh, that's the question. So what age?
I give you a Ferrari.
What age does somebody have to be before they have the puberty? What age does someone have to be before they have puberty?
This is in English.
What age does someone have to be before they have puberty? What age does somebody have to be before they have puberty?
18. Whatever the law, the land is.
According to this, what age? What age? Okay, so now you're lying. they're deceiving. Okay, so you don't know. You don't know. So what age does a lady have to be?
16 to
18. That's what I asked you.
In Sharia law, what is the age of marriage?
18. I don't know.
Okay, we just
read it. We just read it just now. We just read it to you just now.
There is no age.
There is no age.
You can marry at any age.
You can marry at two.
Any age.
You can marry at one. Bruv, Muhammad was looking at a baby. I'm preparing to get married to her. Don't you get this? My friend.
Why did nobody call him? Why did they call him mad? Soothsayer, but not pedophile. Why?
My friend.
It's not a record.
If you were there, you would disagree with it, right?
Okay.
Let's read.
I'll disagree with you.
Okay. Say no.
You're saying Muhammad is the
baby. Do you not believe that Muhammad said that?
I'm saying this.
This is what Muhammad, listen to this. Listen to this. Okay, let's read this. All right, it says this. I'm going to read you two sources. Yeah? It says, Muhammad saw Habiba, the daughter of Abbas, while she was Fatim, which is age of nursing. And he said, if she grows up while I'm still alive, I will marry her. Okay, and that's from Masnad Ahmad 25636. Let me read you another one. Okay. Invert. This is the life of the Muhammad. He doesn't even know about this. Okay. Brother, listen to what I'm saying. It's the life of Muhammad. It's different from the hadith. Listen. It says, in the Riwaya of Yunus, it says, I recorded that the apostle saw her when she was a baby crawling before him and said, if she grows up and I am still alive, that means he must have been a very old man, I will marry her, but he died before she grew up. Wait. And Sufyan Aswad married her and she bore him Rizqa. So do you understand what he just said? Where did he say dream? Where did he say dream? Where did he say he had a dream?
In the hadith.
Baba, show up. Okay, show up. Bring it up. Go, bring it up.
Muhammad had a dream. Came to his best friend, the son, the father of Aisha. He said, I had a dream. I can't believe it. I was married to your daughter. And he said something like this. And then he said, yes, this is from Allah. Marry my daughter. Now, the people didn't say, hey, look, he's not mad. He's a pedophile. Why did they call him a pedophile?
Okay, John, my friend.
Okay, no problem.
My friend, you're avoiding the question.
No problem. But did Aisha herself willingly have sex with Muhammad?
We don't know.
Yes.
We don't know. So it wasn't willing marriage.
You know when he went to Mecca?
It wasn't a willful marriage.
You know when he left Mecca?
So you don't know.
You don't know. You know when he left Mecca?
You don't even know if it was willing.
You know when he left Mecca?
You don't know.
You know when he left Mecca?
My friend.
You know when he left Mecca?
My friend, I want you to, but I want you to be honest.
No, no, I didn't.
Okay, brother, don't avoid. No, he's avoiding. No, he's avoiding the subject. Okay. According to this, Muhammad saw a baby and said he would marry her when she's older. According to your hadith in Sahih Bukhari, Muhammad consummated a marriage with Aisha when she was 9 years old. So, your role model, Muhammad, had sex with a young 9-year-old child, which confirms, hold on, which confirms what Allah instructed in the Quran. Do you not see that? Okay, wait.
This guy is a liar, man.
13 plus 9.
He's a deceiver, man.
Yeah.
My friend, hold on. Do you agree? Wait 1 second.
It's not Islamic. What? It's not a cultural.
Okay, let's do this.
You're making
it. John, no.
Okay. He's using you as a scapegoat.
John, no.
Okay, my friend. Is it okay to have sex with a child under 10 years old?
Does the law say yes? No, it's okay.
I'm asking you. Hey, would you allow your daughter to have sex with a child under 10 years old?
Does the law of the land?
My friend, you're not answering the question. I've asked you a direct question. Right. So according to the Sharia law, there is no age limit. Now he's using people around as a scapegoat.
Wait. Wait, I'm coming. Yeah. Why don't you listen to your fellow citizens? Wait, brother, okay. Expose your brother here, man.
So what this guy is hearing, he's not answering directly.
What does Sharia law say?
What does Sharia law say?
The Sharia law says follow the law of the land.
Sorry?
The Sharia law says follow the law of the land.
No, it doesn't.
The Quran says follow the law of the land.
You're making things up.
That's Sharia law.
You're making things up. Quran, John Doe.
Ask you the same question.
John Doe.
That's a good question.
The Quran says follow the law of the land.
Okay, what about when
Sharia law?
Okay, what about when Sharia law takes
follow the law of the land?
Okay, John Doe. John Doe. What about when Sharia law takes over the land? What happens then?
But we just read it for you.
Then we'll talk about it then.
Because I wouldn't want my daughter to hear
you. Would you see a baby and say, I'll marry her? Would you look at a baby and say, well, you know what? When she's old, I'm going to marry her. What type of mind? What we're trying to paint to you a picture is how a mind has to be to look at a baby and say, well, hold on, when she grows up, I'll marry her. That's what the problem we have here. That's what we're pointing out.
But why didn't you marry them?
You're still not getting it. You don't get it.
I get what you said.
I'm saying to you that only a sick, perverted mind would look at a baby and say, a sick, perverted man. This guy's not listening. He's not interested in the truth. So have you answered? Have you answered?
No, he hasn't.
He's gone to apostasy now.
I'm
going to expose the apostasy.
Okay. So what's your point?
My point is, you know, when they fought in the Battle of Badr, some disbelievers were supposed to die in that battle, but they treated the believers and said to the Muslims, don't kill me, I'll be a Muslim. So they said, okay, you could be Muslim. They came with the Muslims. But God knows these people are lying.
All right,
they're not really Muslim.
Okay,
let me finish.
Let me read it.
So they didn't want to die.
Let me read it.
Like I said about the Ferrari.
How did you avoid this stuff?
Because Muhammad told us this.
Muhammad told you this.
He doesn't understand. Now you're being like a joker now. Muhammad told you this?
No, of course not.
No. Me, physically.
Muhammad said if anyone leaves his Islamic religion, kill him.
No.
Brother, what is this?
I didn't say that.
We need real Muslims here. No, the basics.
Because the Quran says
that's the basics.
Brother, do you know what that word means?
Okay, you said that. Okay, let's read it.
So how can
get
you
the
say?
Get the apostles
or
you said kill him. You got it. Yeah, Sahih Bukhari.
I'll have to find it.
You can just say like when you leave Islam. You can find it.
Okay, I'll find it.
I'm gonna read the Quran.
Okay,
all right.
John Doe,
explain the war of apostasy.
Yeah.
All this word apostasy exists.
John Doe. Let me read your Quran.
You don't get it.
Let me read your Quran. Let me read your Quran.
You said there's no compulsion of religion.
And he's going to read the war
of apostasy. I should be speaking to him. Because every time I speak to him, he's got a dialogue with me. We understand each other.
Are you a Muslim?
He might not agree, but he understands everything. If I speak to him now, he'll get it.
Okay. Let me read your Quran.
Call him.
Okay, let me read your Quran.
He's trying to avoid you.
Let me finish what I'm saying.
No.
You're jumping.
We're going to disprove what you just said.
Exactly. What I'm trying to say is
about
this.
About apostasy, no. We're going to disprove it.
Okay.
Can I disprove it?
Can I finish 10 seconds?
Let me say 10 seconds.
In the Quran, it says this. There's no compulsion in religion. This means there's no force. You can't be forced. So if you're Muslim and you leave, they can't force you to be Muslim because it goes against the Quran.
Over.
There's no compulsion in religion.
10 seconds over.
Finito.
All right, let's read it. Let's read it.
All you're talking about is a man-made law.
John, I just want you to listen to this, yeah? This is what I say. They are eager that you should disbelieve. Like they have disbelieved. So that you all become alike. So don't make friends from among them until they migrate in the way of Allah. But if they turn their backs, size them and kill them wherever you find them, and do not take from among them friends or helpers.
What
you just said about compulsion contradicts this.
No, it doesn't. Can I say why?
I've read the test.
Can I say why the Quran doesn't contradict itself? This verse.
So you're creating your own Islam.
Okay, who's it talking about? The people.
Where's
what people? The Quraysh. Thank you.
Okay.
So can I finish? Were they not fighting the Muslims, early Muslims?
No.
No?
There's no battle here.
Before this.
What was the apostasy battle?
This is when they made peace.
No,
And God's saying now, if these people turn away, can I finish before you know what I'm saying?
Turn away from what?
He doesn't know what I'm going to say, and he's saying I've got it wrong.
Turn away from what?
I've not even finished the whole thing.
Rambo, turn away from what?
5 seconds.
Turn away from
Christians. Insults.
Answer the question.
Where's the love? Where's I'll pray for you, bro. None of that. It's just like Rambo.
No, you said you're Rambo.
But you know my name's not Rambo. I just don't want to give you my real name.
I don't know if your name's
Rambo.
I don't want you, Stephen.
Or John, or Matthew. I've known you for many years and they know your first name.
I've never seen you before. So you say you're Rambo, so I'll call you Rambo.
Call me Muslim. Call me John Doe. That's it.
Or John Doe.
John, there's no need Rambo, John. What I'm trying to say to you, the point is that you just made a verse, now you're scared. You made a comment, I'm scared. He don't want to let me finish. You showed a verse, go to your verse about killing it anyway.
Brother,
his verse is about the battle. When they had a battle, after the battle was finito. Yes, I can. I'm doing it now. After the battle was finished.
Show us the source.
After the battle was finished.
What's the source? What's the source? What is the source? What is the source?
I just want the source. I just want the source.
Quran.
Brother, you made up a lot of stuff.
Where in the Quran? I've got. There's 114 chapters in the Quran.
Sahih Bukhari.
It's the classical Arabic. Doesn't matter.
So the
book is revealed in classical Arabic. The angel spoke to Muhammad in classical Arabic. When I ask him, can you speak a classical Arabic? No. Doesn't matter.
Why should he?
But they understand the Quran. They don't understand the languages.
You made up a lot of stuff.
They all know the Quran.
Okay.
English.
John Doe.
English.
Oh, okay. Should we just read it? Should we just read Sahih Bukhari? No, you've been finishing for a long time. You keep lying.
So
let's read this.
No.
So, hold on.
He's prophet.
Hold on.
No, let's read what your prophet
said. Okay, let's see what the prophet Muhammad said.
Sahih
Bukhari.
Wait.
9:184:57. It says, whoever changed his Islamic religion, then kill him.
Exactly.
That's your hand.
This is Bukhari.
This is the law of apostasy.
No.
We want to know.
Do you
agree with Muhammad or are you against Muhammad?
But when I
do you acknowledge what Muhammad said?
Don't panic.
Yeah. Do you?
The question is,
do you agree with that?
Should I prove to you that I want to know the truth?
You don't
want
to prove to you. Why are you afraid? Do you agree with the hadith? Do you agree with the hadith? John, no, you don't agree with the hadith, do you?
You know if you agree, you'll let me.
Well, but I'm not Muslim.
Okay.
It's Muhammad that tells you to kill unbelievers. I'm not Muslim.
Are you alright?
Are you alright?
Do you agree with
Muhammad? I was speaking to him earlier and you jumped in filming me.
Brother, do you agree with the hadith?
And he's asking me.
Do you agree with the hadith?
Yeah, whatever. He was doing it.
You're the victim?
And I said, I don't want to...
Why are Muslims so emotional? Why are Muslims so sensitive?
In English Quran.
My friend, it's very clear.
I've got the Arabic.
So I'm trying to answer him.
I've got the Arabic.
I'm scared.
I've got the Arabic.
They don't want to hear the answer.
Okay.
They don't want to let me finish speaking.
Okay, so.
Can I answer his question?
No, we want to know.
No, we won't go.
What was the question?
I'm just going to go. Don't say, oh,
what was the question? You can run away if you want, we don't mind. You can run if you want, we don't care. It's up to you.
I'll prove to you they're not sincere. They won't let me finish. Watch this.
Okay.
All of you.
Let him rumble on for a minute.
Yeah, give him one.
Go on. I say, I'll prove to you they're not sincere. They won't let me finish.
All right, go on.
Right. This verse is talking about an event that happened in the past. So what happened was they were fighting the disbelievers. The Muslims won. Some of the disbelievers on the battlefield went like that, I'll be Muslim. So the Muslims say, okay, you want to be Muslim. They don't know if they're lying or not. Only God knows. So they became Muslim there and then on the battlefield. And they came back with the Muslim. Everything's all good. Now the verse says, if these people turn their backs, because they asked Muhammad, what people? Should we kill every single disbeliever? Muhammad said, no. The ones that fought us, some of them became Muslim on the battlefield. If these individuals, and they all know who they are, become disbelievers, then you kill them. Because these people should have died on the battlefield. It was only because they said to the person, forgive me, I want to be Muslim. So they said, okay, we'll forgive you, you're Muslim. So God knows in the heart of these people, they're liars, they're going to cause mischief, just like these two are trying to do with these Muslims and these other hate preachers. They're trying to cause like division, and then they want the press to come in to go, look at the Muslims fighting, it's all the same. That's what they want to do.
Okay, so, one minute is gone. We didn't.
I said, well, you wouldn't let me finish.
We've let you speak. Now respond. You spoke to him?
They can't.
Okay, go and respond.
The Holy Spirit is not in them.
I want him to listen, John.
Okay. No Holy Spirit.
Don't worry about him. Just talk. Just
talk. You know how I know? Because the Holy Spirit came to the world.
No, no, because I want him to answer the question.
Okay.
John, hello. John.
See, now he's trying to avoid. No, he's. No, he's. He's trying to deflect by speaking to someone else, hoping that this will go away. Listen, this is like a bad dream for Unit.
What's my name?
This is a bad dream for Unit.
Listen,
stop avoiding the subject. Listen to what we're saying to you. Okay, just speak.
Why does he talk about we're hate preachers when we clearly read the Quran? The Quran says if they leave their religion, kill them.
Kill them.
So we're hate preachers for reading what the Quran says.
Exactly.
That's what I clearly said. And the other thing is, wait. The other thing is,
John Doe. You have the Holy Spirit. Stop calling me John Doe. If you've got the Holy Spirit, okay. Call me by my real name.
Earlier on, he said his name is John Doe.
Yeah, so he lied.
We're calling him John Doe, but now he's been offended by that. Yeah. I don't understand this guy. All right, what's your name?
There's no Holy Spirit.
Should I call you John?
Ask the Holy Ghost.
John,
Why are you changing the topic?
John, Jesus, I don't blame you. He keeps changing the topic.
Okay.
And then Godwin read on Sahih al-Bukhari, that if anyone leaves the Islamic religion, kill them. Who said that? His prophet. The false prophet Muhammad is the one who said that. And then the Quran clearly says, if they leave, kill them. Size them and kill them wherever you find them.
Correct.
And then now this guy is telling us it's in a battle, but he's not giving us the sources. We've asked him countless times, where is the battle of the apostasy law? But he can't show us.
Okay.
Got nothing to say, man.
So yeah, so what can we say? Is there any Muslims that can answer for my friend here? Is there any Muslims that can answer for this friend?
John.
You can't answer, John, so is there anyone that can answer?
Have a civilized conversation.
No, forget about him, he's not interested.
Why are you going there? Talk to us! Why are you scared? You're talking to him, talk to us! We are here!
I asked him one question originally.
We are here!
Bad questions, loads of questions.
No, we asked you one question.
Don't panic.
Where's the original Hebrew?
Wow.
Where's the original Hebrew?
This guy is scared, man.
Why are you afraid? To deal with your own Quran and your own hadith.
It's the original Hebrew.
Why are you afraid?
I'm asking him a question.
He's going there.
Okay.
He's going there.
So this is typical Muslims. What do you do?
Typical Muslim. He can't answer a question. Yes. He deflects because he's scared.
That's correct.
Embarrassed.
And then on top of that, he starts to make up stuff. We ask them, where's their source? Give us some kind of confirmation of what they're saying. And they'll just continue to ramble on.
Exactly.
And so what can we do? We are here to engage with Muslims who are sincere and who genuinely want to see what the Quran says and what the Sharia law says. And what we want to do is also give them an alternative. Because right now, if they continue on following on this your Prophet Muhammad, my friend, eventually, yeah, your Prophet Muhammad. Eventually, what will happen is you'll be led astray. And so we'll just call you to Jesus Christ.
Antichrist.
God bless.
Okay,
let's go.
Do you have the source of the apostasy?